not 50 years ago was the release of the Beatles, commonly known as the White Album. Our Beatle historian is here with some behind-the-scenes stories from the making of that album. Good Day LA starts right now.
Lovely. Oh, there we go. There's a reason why we're playing this song, right? I just love it. I may be biased. The Beatles' Lovely Rita is from the Sgt. Pepper album. Last year, we actually celebrated the 50th anniversary of that incredible record, generally recognized as one of the greatest rock albums ever. But now there's a re-release that may be even more epic. Listen.
Singing in the dead of night. Take these broken wings and let
showing off an incredible mix of ballads and rockers and showcasing the band in spectacular style. That album was called simply The Beatles. But because of its minimalistic cover, it's known to most as the White Album, and it was released 50 years ago this month. For that reason, joining us. Also, I want to mention the new 6-disc collection is a treasure trove for Beatles fans. Joining us now is an old friend of the show, humorist, producer, I can go on and on. He's also a Beatles historian, Martin Lewis, or should I say Sir Martin Lewis?
Just Martin will do fine.
Just Martin, or I should call you the fifth Beatle.
I'm the 19th Beatle. I think there's some others.
19th Beatle. Okay, I like that, Martin. Take me back to 1968. It was just before the holidays when this album was released.
It was. Of course, I don't remember it very well. I was only about 3 years old at the time. But it was an amazing, because 1968 was a very busy year in politics, both in America and around the rest of the world. And the Beatles came out with this record, and everyone was thinking, how do they follow Sgt. Pepper? It was such a landmark. And it was on such a pedestal.
It was so huge. How do you top that?
They did it very simply. They didn't try to top it. They just did what they did naturally, which was write songs. And the interesting thing was that most artists, be they singers or bands, tended to come up with a sound, and they just do more of the same in different variations. The Beatles were such lovers of music generally that they came up with songs in every different style, from folk, jazz, blues, country, vaudeville, avant-garde, or even the beginnings of heavy metal.
And Martin, you brought in some memorabilia with us. I want to focus on this red. This is not an album. What is this? Because they actually put this film together in India?
This is actually a book. It's called The Beatles in India. The Beatles had been on the hamster wheel for 6 years doing records, and they'd been doing records and films and everything like that. And they took off for a few weeks to go to India to learn meditation. And while they the Maharishi. And while they were there, what they did was they took their guitars with almost like a hobby.
Yeah.
They ended up, they were supposed to be studying meditation. They wrote 40 new songs, 40 new songs in that time. And there was a Canadian chap who'd gone to India to mend a broken heart, found himself at the ashram studying with the Beatles. And so he didn't know the Beatles were going to be there, took out his camera, took some photographs, and this is a book. And some of the photos we've seen are of the Beatles composing those songs in India.
Can I ask you, Martin, so the Beatles, we all know what happened in the 70s, right? They decided to go their separate ways. Do you see on this particular album individual personalities, maybe even a little bit of tension come out?
There is a little bit of tension, natural tension. The Beatles were like four brothers, and if you got a brother or a sister, you know sometimes there are tensions in a family. But what actually happened was that they were exploring, they were enjoying their music, they all started going off in little directions, but they still came together for the key moments. Mm-hmm. And there are moments here, for example, that are unexpected. Paul McCartney, we always think of him as the beautiful balladeer, Yesterday Michelle, here, there, and everywhere. He's the one who does Helter Skelter, the most raucous rock and roll song. And John Lennon, the tough one, is the one who does Julia, a beautiful song about his mother who died young. And it's heartbreaking, the intimacy of it. So in these, ultimately, this album with 30 different songs, it was like a Bayeux tapestry of music. It was like the State of the Union of contemporary music. And all the other artists that followed them followed. So suddenly you got singer-songwriters and heavy metal, and all the other music followed the Beatles.
And it just continues to resonate with every single generation that just continues to be born. So, Martin, thank you so much for coming in. We really appreciate it. Mm-hmm. And you can see more of those amazing pictures in that book that you were talking about.
That's right.
right there. We're going to post it on our website as well. The 6 CD set called the White Album Super Deluxe. It's available now at the usual places. Martin, we appreciate you coming in. Sounds like another stocking stuffer to me.
Absolutely. You need a big stocking.
Yeah, we do. A big one. Vanessa.
Man, our stockings are getting really stuffed with stuff from today, Rita. Thank you. And you're so lucky. You have a Beatles song after you. All right, so to come, we first told you about...